Good evening, and I welcome you students. We will be discussing some important questions from the topic of chemical bonding. Before we begin our session, we have 1 to 2 minutes of breathing exercise to relieve of the tension, the stresses. We will be doing Nadi Shuddhi. What is that? It means, students, what I will do, these are my two fingers I am keeping here. This is my right nostril, I am closing it. I will inhale from the left, hold it, exhale from the right. Then I will close the left, inhale from the right, hold the breath, exhale from the left. We can take 3 rounds here, but in everyday life you can do it many times, 5 to 10 times, 5 to 10 rounds, you can do 3 times a day. This gives good relaxation. It's a good relaxation technique. Are you ready, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, close your eyes. And we are going to start, students. Inhale from the left. Hold, exhale from the right, inhale from the right, hold, exhale from the left. The longer you breathe, the better it is. Inhale from the left, hold, you can count 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Exhale from the right. So like this, you can do many times in a day, students. I'm coming to the normal state. Normal breathing, inhale, exhale. Rub your hands. Heat is produced, that healing energy on your face, on your eyes for 30 seconds. Gently massage your face, eyes, and come back to the normal state. How was it?
Good, sir.
We are trying to relax ourselves. We are trying to. Those relaxing techniques are very important. Breathing is the part of our life. Okay, all right,
students. All right, students. We have a very good session coming up today. And today's topic is chemical bonding, which you have studied already. Chemical bonding, students, we will be solving some MCQ questions on chemical bonding. They can be important for any exams which you are appearing, students. So before we talk of chemical bonding, students, can give me some introduction. What is a chemical bond, student? You say there is a bond, atoms combine to form molecules. Why do they combine to form molecules? There is an electrostatic force which is holding these atoms together, students. And what type of bonds you studied, student? Covalent?
Covalent and ionic.
And ionic bonds you have studied. What is the theory which was given by Lewis? What is Lewis octet rule, students?
It states that atoms, when they will combine, they will achieve stable octet.
As you know, the basic fundamental is that things are recombining, atoms are combining because they want to be stable. If they are not stable, student, they will try to combine and become more stable. So then Lewis has given an octet rule that atoms will combine in order to get octet because noble gases have octet, so they are quite stable, student. That was the first clue. And then after that, we were able to draw the Lewis electron dot structures. They are important. Lewis electron dot structures are very useful in organic chemistry. Also, we have seen that these structures help us in identifying the mechanism of the reactions. Everything in the reaction is a movement of the electrons. How the electrons move will decide the reaction. What type of intermediates are formed? More stable intermediates are likely to be formed. So they give us a good nature of the mechanism, and the stable intermediate decide the major products which are formed in organic reactions. We already know General Organic Chemistry, which uploaded many lectures on that. So students, we are aware that a bond will be formed, and then we have discussed in this, what else we discussed in this student, we have discussed how to give a Lewis electron dot structure representation, octet rule, and what are the limitations of this. Then we have discussed bond lengths and bond enthalpies, how the bonds are formed, bond parameters were discussed, students, bond enthalpy was discussed, bond angles were discussed in this chapter. We have discussed what type of bond orders are there. We have also discussed what is resonance, when you can draw more than one possible structure like benzene and others. Then we have also discussed the polarity of the bonds and dipole moment. What is a dipole moment? What is a dipole moment, students?
Dipole moment is the product of charge and the distance.
So we discussed the bonds are polar, and then we discussed, student, the shapes of the molecules, that molecules have shapes. The shapes of the molecules were discussed by using VSEPRT, valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, student. What is electron pair repulsion theory, students? Valence shell electron pair repel. Valence shell electron pairs repel, and when the valence shell electron pairs will repel, means one pair is forming one bond or there is a lone pair, students. When they will repel, they will try to go farther away from each other, and that will decide the what we are talking about, the molecular geometries which we discuss, students. And lone pairs are not visible when we discuss the molecular geometry. That is important. We discussed about that also. Then we discussed the valence bond theory, student, that how the bonds are being formed, orbital overlap concept, and then the overlapping of the atomic orbitals were discussed. But after that, there was some difficulty in explaining the shapes of molecules like CH4, etc. Then we talked of hybridization, that these atomic orbitals will get mixed up to form more equivalent hybrid orbitals, which are going to form more stable bonds. So more lowering of energy will take place. Therefore, we have discussed different type of hybridization. What hybridization we have discussed, student?
sp3 sp2 sp.
Then what other, student?
sp3d
d sp2 and sp3d2
sp3d3.
So all these types of hybrid orbitals are there when the molecules are formed, students. We also discussed the molecular orbital theory in this chapter, that how we can draw the molecular orbitals. There are atomic orbitals overlap to form bonding and antibonding orbitals, and how it can explain the paramagnetic behavior of O2. Energy level diagrams, they were drawn, students, and we could find bond order and stability. The stability, higher the bond order, more stable the molecule, we have already indicated. Then we discussed something very important about the hydrogen bonding. And there were two types of hydrogen bondings are being discussed, students.
Intermolecular and intramolecular.
Intermolecular and intramolecular. What is the difference between the two, students?
In intermolecular hydrogen bonding, the bond is formed between two different molecules. In intramolecular, it is formed within the same molecule.
Same molecule. If they give you H2O, student, and H3, students, CH triple bond, CH, students, C2H4. Students, what are the hybridizations of oxygen?
In water, it is sp3.
sp3. What is the hybridization in ammonia, students?
In ammonia, it is again sp3.
sp3. What is?
Then it is sp.
sp.
It is in sp2.
sp2. If they say predict the shape of ClF3 molecule using VSEPR repulsion theory, students.
It should be.
You don't give an answer without doing anything. I told my students are very clear. There's nothing to hurry up, student. You will get time in exam to do the questions. Blind answers will be wrong. And once you work out, the answer will be 100% correct. That is the way to do the questions in the paper.
It is ClF3. It should be trigonal bipyramidal.
Trigonal bipyramidal. I try to check your answer again.
No, sir, it is a T shape actually.
But I have told you one thing very clearly. Why I give all these exercises, brain exercises? Why do we do brain exercises? Why do we do certain breathing techniques now? Why are we doing all that? There is a purpose, student. We are trying to sharpen our mind. At the same time, we know that we will not answer a question in a hurry. I repeatedly tell my student, do it and then answer the question. If I know what is valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, what hybridization, what shape is visible to us, the lone pairs are not visible to us, that you should know about that and where they are located so that the repulsions are minimized. That we know how many lone pairs are there, how many bond pairs are there, how many the bond pairs or the electron domains, total 5, out of which 2 lone pairs are there, where the 2 lone pairs will go, students. So when we discuss like this, student, what we said, okay, just a minute, student, the pictures should be in our mind when we do the question, students, what we are trying to say. How many, there are 3 F bonds to be formed, student.
And then 2 lone pair there.
Okay. That is the thing, they are going to repel, these lone pairs are going to repel, student, and the result of that will be what it is, a bent T shape, little bit of that. So you can see all these things we are in our mind, students, when we solve questions. And the more we practice, the better we are for the coming papers. That is very, very essential and important point, students. Okay. Now we are coming to MCQ questions. Chemical bonding. Chemical bonding. Huh? The bond length between hybridized carbon atom and other carbon atom is minimum. Is minimum in propane, butane, propene, propyne. You should first draw the structures and write the hybridization of each carbon, and then you will see the answer coming up.
Yes, sir. The answer is coming to be propane D.
Propane, what is propane? This is our propane. What is butane? CH3, CH2, CH3. What is propene? What is propine, students? What is the hybridization here?
SP3.
So there are single covalent bonds.
Yes.
Single covalent bond. You know what is the length of the single covalent bond? About 1.45 angstrom. Is it here? It is sp2 and sp3. What is the double bond? That carbon-carbon double bond is around 1.34 angstrom. This is sp.
SP.
Triple bond. The bond length could be about 1.20 angstrom, which is the shortest.
SP1, propane.
SP. The important point is the maximum S character is here. Where is the maximum S character?
In SP.
Maximum S character in SP, student, what it will do? This hydrogen will become acidic. S orbital attracts the electron more strongly towards itself. The result will be these hydrogen will become more acidic. They will become ionizable. You know, when you react with sodium, what happens? Sodium acetylide will be formed. You are aware of that in organic chemistry. It has an application. It has a use, students. See, from one question, how many questions I discuss? That is our point. Next question is on the screen, students. Question number 2. The number of nodal planes present in S into S antibonding orbitals is?
Should be 1.
What do you mean by a nodal plane, student?
Where there is no electron.
Where the probability of finding the electron is 0.
Is 0.
We are saying probability of finding electron is 0, students. So in the SNS antibonding orbital, what will happen? There will be one nodal plane. One nodal plane where there will be no probability of finding the electron. The hybrid state in SO2 molecule is what is the atomic number of sulfur, students? 16.
16.
What is the valence shell electron configuration?
PP4.
3H2, 3P4, students.
It should be SP2.
If you have 3S. 3P, what will happen? This is 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now there are two oxygens coming. What is oxygen? 1S2, 2S2, 2P4. Oxygen needs two electrons. Oxygen forms a double bond, students.
Yes, sir.
Then how the double bonds will be formed, students? So what will happen then? If I remove these electrons, where will they go? If I write something like 3s, 3v, and there is a 3d, what happens? What will happen? Each oxygen needs two students. And if I consider sp2, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If each sulfur and oxygen, what will happen? SO2. One lone pair, if I need that, what, there is no need to do that. I will put it here. And what has happened now? One electron is, one oxygen will need two. Out of which, if I do this sp2, then one these will form sigma bonds. And this two will be left, they will form
pi bonds
with oxygen. Always one sigma, then the next has to be pi bonds.
Yes, sir.
So in other words, what is happening? sp2 hybridization is there. And then if I use the domains or electron, how many domains are there? Then also you can see sulfur, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this one oxygen double bond, then there you left with this two electrons. So there are two, what do you get? Two bond pairs and two domains of the bond pair, one lone pair. Then what is the result of that? SO2 is sp2 hybridized.
Yes, sir.
sp2 hybridized. Question number 4 is coming, students. Which one of the following does not have sp2 hybridized orbital? You should try to draw the structures of these first, then you will be able to do it.
Yes, sir. The answer is acetone nitrile C.
Acetone, what is the formula of acetone?
COCH3.
What is the formula of acetic acid?
CH3C.
What is acetone nitrile?
H3C.
What is acetamide?
CH3CH2.
So then what is the correct answer?
Acetonitrile.
Because there is no double bond here. sp2 carbon. The correct answer is acetonitrile. This carbon is sp hybridized. Triple bond is there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right, students. Which one of the following will have lowest boiling point, student? Lowest boiling point. Draw the structures of them, then only you will know.
lowest boiling point 2,2-dimethylpropane C.
What is this 1,2,3-butane? CH3, CH2, CH. What is this? 2-methylpropane. 1, 2, 3. 2-methylpropane. What is this? 2,2-dimethylpropane. CH3, CH2, 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 CH3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many carbons are there here? Five.
Five.
How many? Five. Five. How many are in this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Only four carbons.
Yes.
Then carbon number is less here.
But sir, branching here is more in 2,2-dimethylpropane.
That I seen. Atomic mass is also, there are two factors, atomic mass and branching. When atomic masses are same, comparisons are made, students. Here, the atomic mass will be less as compared to this. Actually, the question should be more appropriate, which has the highest boiling point.
Yes, sir. Highest will then, it will be pentane.
Normal pentane.
Yes, sir.
Because there are not one factor, then how will we decide if more than one factor is there in some question, students? Okay. When questions are given, we should know which factor will be superseding the other factor. When molecular masses are almost equal, then comparison is made on the basis of straight chain or branch.
Okay.
Otherwise, then again, we will be, some confusion. We don't know the exact values, which there are more than one factors. Then we have to be sure what we want to say. Next question is coming on the screen, student. Among the following, maximum covalent character is shown by the compound. Maximum covalent character. Where did we study covalent character, student?
Fajans rule.
What is Fajans rule, student?
Fajans rule, maximum covalent character will be shown by that compound in which the size of the cation is the smallest, size of anion is largest.
Charge by size, what we call density of the ion.
Yes, sir.
Density of the ion. What our answer will be in this case, students?
It should be AlCl3.
AlCl3 is the correct answer. What is that? Mg is 2+, Fe is 2+. Two plus and Al3+. So maximum polarizability. Maximum what we call as polarizability of anion by the cation. Polarization of the cation by the anion. Smallest, high charge, small size, it will polarize. Therefore, the maximum covalent character will be shown by AlCl3 is the correct answer. All right. Next question is coming, student. Among the following, Richard, dipole-dipole are the major interactions. Dipole-dipole are the major interaction present in. Benzene and ethanol, acetone, nitrile and acetone, KCl and water, benzene and carbon tetrachloride, student. First, we should be able to write their structures, then only we can say what is the value coming student.
It should be acetonitrile and acetone.
Benzene. What is benzene? And ethanol. Acetonitrile. And acetone. K plus Cl minus and water. Ionic. Benzene. And CCl4. Where will the dipole? This is negative, this is positive. And in this case, what happens, student? You know. So dipole-dipole interaction, maximum wear. Acetonitrile. And acetone. See, the charge separation is taking place where more electronegative element and less electronegative element, we can do it. Next question is coming on the screen, students.
Charge balance, it will come as 3.
How? What is beryllium? What is the charge of beryllium?
Here the charge of beryllium is 2+.
Aluminium?
3+.
Silicon?
4+.
Which group for group 14? Oxygen?
2-.
-2. Then how will we do? 2 into N plus 3 into 2 plus 4 into 6. Yes. -2 into 18 is equal to 0. What is the value of N? How much it is coming, students? Without doing, do not answer any question because then we will be in trouble.
Sir, 3.
3?
Yes, sir.
Okay, answer is 3. Which of the following type of hybridization leads to three-dimensional geometry of the bonds around the carbon atom, students?
It should be sp3c.
What is sp? Sp what? Linear.
Linear.
What is sp2? Triangular planar. What is sp3? This is sp3.
Yes.
Three dimensional. All right. An element A has 3 electrons in outermost orbit and B has 6 electrons in the outermost. The formula of the compound between these two will be. How will we write the formula of the compounds?
It will be has 3 electrons, 6 electrons atom per bit. So it should be A2B3B.
A2B3. A has how many? 3 electrons.
3.
And B has 6
electrons.
2, 4, 6. Each B will need you 2 electrons to complete the octet. 2 electrons to complete the octet. So you have 3, you need 3 into 2, 6 electrons. 6 electrons. If you are 6, then it needs 3. Then 3, it has 2 into 3 is a 6. So B, you need 2 B and 3 A. What is that? A 2. B3, you have seen Al2O3.
Yes, sir.
What is Al2O3? Aluminium 3 plus and oxygen minus 2. All right. A2?
B3.
A2, B3. Okay. We have to think and think, students. The maximum number of hydrogen bonds that a molecule of water can have.
Water molecule. So it should be 4.
How many maximum number of hydrogen bonds water molecule can form? One water molecule can form 4 hydrogen bonds, students. One water molecule can form. This one can be associated with 4. So one water molecule is surrounded by four hydrogen bonds. Okay. Next question is coming, students. The number of types of bonds between two carbon atoms in calcium carbide, student, calcium carbide.
Calcium carbide.
Is a What type of compound is calcium carbide?
There will be one sigma and two pi bonds.
What is that? Calcium 2 plus.
Yes, sir.
What is the structure of this C2 2 minus? This is carbide. So what is in this? 1 sigma and?
2 pi.
1 sigma and 2 pi. Okay. 1 sigma and 2 pi bonds. All right. Question number 13 is coming on the screen, student. Based on lattice enthalpy and other consideration, which of the following metal chloride is expected to have higher melting point? Higher melting point. What is lattice enthalpy, student? What is lattice enthalpy?
It is the energy required to separate one mole of ionic compound into gaseous ions.
If you have something like this, then energy is required. Energy is required, and when they are formed, the same amount of energy is released. What are the factors on which lattice enthalpy depends? What are the important factors on which lattice enthalpy depends, students?
It depends on the charge of the ions and the size of the ions.
Important point. Charge and ionic radii. Higher the charge, what will happen if charge increases? Lattice enthalpy will increase or decrease?
It will increase.
Higher the charge, more the lattice enthalpy. Then ionic radii, larger the ionic radii.
Lesser will be the lattice enthalpy.
Lesser the lattice enthalpy. Then now try to find the answer, students. Basically, see revision of the so many things here. Revision of the so many questions which we do. In every question, that is the reason we do all these things.
NaCl.
Why? Cl minus is same in all of them.
Yes, sir.
Then, what is happening?
The size of the alkali metal is increasing. so rubidium and KCl will have lesser lattice enthalpy.
Then what there is a lithium also,
but lithium chloride would have lower melting point due to covalent nature. It is covalent, so it will have lower.
So here were two factors which were involved. One is the lattice enthalpy. See, sometimes the question could be confusing. Second, the crystal lattice structure. The binding energy lattice enthalpy will be maximum if you consider lithium chloride, because lithium has smallest size.
Yes, sir.
But NaCl, you know it, what type of structure it has? Sodium chloride. So the crystal lattice structure, and then it becomes higher melting point. Sometimes this question, because he should have given these three, this is now again a problem, because lithium size is smallest. You know, lithium fluoride has the highest lattice enthalpy. It is insoluble in water. Question has been put up many times. Next question is coming on the screen, students. Dipole-induced dipole interactions are present in which of the following pairs? What I'm saying, dipole-induced dipole interactions. What is a dipole-dipole? What type of interactions you have studied?
London forces or dispersion forces.
Van der Waals interactions, what we studied? London
dispersion forces.
What else?
Dipole-dipole.
Dipole-dipole. Next.
Dipole-induced dipole.
Next.
Ion-ion interaction.
Where is ion-ion interaction? That is not Van der Waals.
Not ion. It was.
Ions are not involved in this Van der Waals forces. Hydrogen bonding, did you not study in so important? Maximum, this is most important factor in Van der Waals forces. You have seen how it changes the properties of the substances. Where is the dipole, induced dipole in this case? Do not answer any question without doing it.
It is HCl and helium.
What is happening in water? This is negative, this is positive. You have alcohol. What will happen in this case? Where hydrogen bond, Cl2 and CCl4, both are nonpolar. Cl. This also has a zero dipole. This also has a zero dipole. Okay? You know what is happening? Zero dipole. HCl, what is HCl? Negative, positive, and helium. This is nonpolar, this is polar. So this has a dipole and induced dipole. Okay. What will happen in SiF4 and helium? SiF4 is a tetrahedral molecule. What will happen then? It is symmetric zero dipole moment. Zero dipole moment. Okay. Because once we do it, then only we should answer it. Not like that. Question number 15. Among the following dipole as major interaction is present in.
Sir, you have already done this.
What question. Is the answer we gave it?
Acetonitrile and acetone B.
Okay. Question number 16th is coming, student. The charge by size ratio of cation determines its polarizing power. Okay. Fajan's rule?
Yes, sir.
Fajan's rule. Charge by size ratio, we are saying. Which one of the following sequences represent the increasing polarizing order or the polarizing power of cationic species? Ka plus Ca Mg2 and like this. Four of them are given, students. Four are given. Which is the correct answer, students?
Here the answer will be D option.
Well, you will, one thing is to be clear out of this, this is K plus. So this will have the largest size and this has a minimum charge.
Yes, sir.
So this should be the least. Minimum should be this. As you can see in the question, there is only one option where K plus is the minimum. Only D part. Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
So naturally, I may not go into more details here. But otherwise, I know these belong to which group? Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, where they are.
Beryllium, calcium and magnesium in group 2.
Group 2. Beryllium, magnesium,
calcium.
Then as you go, the size is increasing.
Yes, sir.
2 plus 2 plus 2 plus. Then what is the correct answer? D is the correct answer.
D.
What I mean to say, as questions you will do and practice, students, there will be some clues also. And as we practice more and more, we can apply our intelligence and common sense. Out of the four, two choices are always bad. And only two will be left where you have to take a decision. And that's why I say that we should try to focus on doing before comparing, but in many cases it may not be possible. Then we know which two bad are there. Then some amount of smartness will be required in answering questions in the various difficult papers. So we may say two are already out, only two are left. And sometimes the clue could be so good that we may not have to waste our time in just studying that. Time is also important factor in many exams. So that is the reason I gave this point. I was not telling you this before that, now I believe sometimes it is important that we are able to solve question as early as possible. Okay. So what tricks can be used, that we will continue more in our next coming lectures. Okay, then I will meet you in the next lecture.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay.